Not Even Gonna Waste No Time, Kendrick Lamar, Mr. Morale, and the Big Steppers. First album in 5 years. On our birthday weekend.
Double album.
Double album. Two nines. You really can't make that up.
Can't make that up. You ass bitch.
You ugly as fuck.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs. You step in the what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they copy up? Copy up us.
To the podcast, and you might have already heard us talk about the artwork, but just to reiterate, we love the artwork. We thought that the artwork was just a classic black,
yeah,
image snapped in time
aesthetic. You
know? From the diamond studded crown of thorns to the what looked like a revolver on the waist.
Mm-hmm.
Baby, the baby's wifey over there with motherhood.
Yeah,
the brown, the caulking on the wall that, look, maybe it was bullets that rang through that joint.
Mm-hmm. And it looks like he's, like, protective. It's almost like a I got y'all type of pick.
Yeah.
Black man in front of his family. Right. Like, he's standing in front of what he cares about.
We started our Kendrick Lamar reaction or listening session, and then when we got to track three, the fucking card went corrupt. Once we got past
Worldwide Steppers.
Worldwide Steppers.
I think I can save our reaction.
Tell them the truth.
I hope you find
brand new Kendrick Lamar 2022.
Tell them the truth.
I've been going through something. 1,855 days. I've been going through something.
What is a bitch in a miniskirt? A man in his feelings with bitter nerve. What is a woman that really hurt? A demon, you're better off killing her. What is a relative? Make a repetitive narrative on how you did it first. That is a predator in reverse. All of your presidents, he with thirst. I wanna get me a therapist. I can debate on my theories and sharing it. Whoa, consolidate all my comparisons. Humble enough because time was imperative. Whoa, started to feel like it's only one answer to everything. I don't know where it is. Whoa, popping a bottle of Claritin. Whoa, is it my head or my arrogance? Whoa.
I feel like we just listened to the beginning of some shit. I don't really have thoughts.
Neither.
I don't have any thoughts. I like it. It's just a lot right now.
Taking and moving like, what am I doing? I'm flipping my time through the Rolodex. Indulging myself in my life and my music. The world that I'm in is a cul-de-sac. The world that we in is just menacing. The demons portray the religionists. Did I grieve different?
Listen to that joint the first time around. I grieve different. Him talking about
like the different situation
passed away. Yeah. I was this old when this happened.
It was also like a welcome back Kendrick track too. Starting the album in like a frantic panic, almost in a way. Like,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying. He talked about getting a therapist and some more shit in that verse.
Yeah.
Take off the foo-foo. Take off the clout chase. Take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the money phone, take off the car loan, take off the flex and the white loss. Take off the weird ass jewelry, I'ma take 10 steps, then I'm taking off top off. Take off the fabricated streams and the microwave memes, it's a real world outside. Take off your idols, take off the runway, take off the Cairo. Take off the Sandro, pay 5 days stay, take off for the meal, hella fine. Take off the far flat.
Let's go, Kendrick, let's go, Kendrick!
Let's go!
I'm ready!
What I'm talking about!
I'm ready!
Alright!
Take all that designer bullshit off and what do you have?
Fuck.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you step in the what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
The world in a panic, the women is stranded, the men on the run. The profits are vanished, the law take advantage. The market is crashing, the industry wants niggas and bitches to sleep in the box while they making a mockery following us. This ain't monopoly, watching for luck. This ain't monogamy, y'all getting fucked. Don't know what the hell is that, I gotta relax when I feel.
Hold on, wait, man. Hold on, wait. This is what we wanted right here. This is what we wanted.
The world in a panic,
the women is stranded, the men on the run, the profits abandoned, the low take advantage, the market is crashing. This thing is going crazy!
The industry wants niggas and bitches to sleep in the box, but they making a mockery, following us. This is not a monopoly. Watching for love, this is not a monopoly. Y'all even want.
All my descendants, they come in my sleep and say I am too real. I'm done with the sensitive, taking it personal, done with the black and the white, the wrong and the right. You
bitch! You ugly. ugly as fuck.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you stepping to what?
You out of pocket.
Oh my God, this track. This track is so fire. This is what we wanted right here. It is. I told Terrell, I did not want Kendrick to come back with some more like conscious shit. I really wanted it to be energetic. And I felt like this track is exactly what we've been waiting for.
Love that this is number two. We love the fact that he named the track N95 and he talked a lot about
taking the mask off,
taking away this fake shit. All of the shit that y'all think matters, that doesn't matter, we just taking all of that shit off. Take this off, take that off. It just reminded us, like, you know, like Terrence was saying, we met a lot of people with masks on.
Yeah.
A lot of people had that N95 on to hide their face.
Yeah.
But now we can, basically like a let's see the real you type.
Yeah.
Fire.
Just such a fire track. The energy, the beat, everything about it. Like some of the shit he was saying, me and Terrell was saying, we could literally break down each song. There could be a video made, I feel like, for each song. So
Kodak Black. Okay, Llama.
Kodak Black.
We were talking about how funny it was to hear Kodak Black on here after that tweet went viral about how they said, imagine the Kendrick Lamar puts an album out and it says featuring Kodak Black.
I'm a killer, he's a killer, she's a killer bitch. We some killers walking zombies trying to scratch that itch. Germophobic, hetero.
I am not for the faint of heart. My genetic build can build multi-universes. The men of gods fumble in my graves. I travel with the team, the Apache life. Centennial was like when Miss Baker screamed at Doughboy. Mixed that with Purple Rain, they interchange the scenes. Happy just to be out the hood.
He said it was like when Miss Baker screamed at Doughboy. Matched that with Purple Rain and exchange the scenes. That's crazy.
I found out that he was a sheriff. That was a win-win because he had locked up Uncle Perry. She paid her daddy sins. Next time I fucked a white bitch was out in Copenhagen. Good kid, Mad City tour. I flourished on them stages. When he asked did I have a problem, I said I might be racist. Ancestors watching me fuck was like retaliation. I'm a killer, he's a killer, she's a killer bitch. We some killers walk.
Ancestors watching me fuck was like retaliation. That's crazy. Caught a couple bodies myself, slid my community. My last Christmas toy drive in Compton handed out eulogies. Not because the rags in the park had red gradient, but because the high blood pressure flooded the catering. And
fire.
Honestly, that's crazy, because he said, I caught a couple bodies myself. I slid my community. And you thinking he's talking about street shit. And he's like, it's not because, it's because I did a toy drive and I handed out eulogies. How? That's the beginning of the funeral.
Right.
Like, almost like we about to put you to rest. And it's not because the red flags was red gradient. It's because high blood pressure flooded the catering. I told Terrence the other day, it's like a running thing, where I heard this dude say, you'll die from a heart attack, and then your family will eat everything that killed you at your repast.
Right.
You die, they have the funeral, the repast, they got fried chicken, and everything that's responsible for your death.
For why you in there.
Fucking heavy from Kendrick, the first three.
I'm telling you, it's ridiculous.
And now we back in the ball game.
And now we right back.
I also like how his son's name is Enoch. I used to work with a guy named Enoch. He's a Enoch. Solid dude. I don't know
who
Enoch.
Yeah.
I hope I'm not too late to set my demons straight. I know I made you wait, but how much can you take? I hope you see the God in me. I hope you can see.
And I'll blast.
If it's up, stay down for me.
I feel you deep. I feel deep.
Trust me, can I trust you? Don't judge me. I'm a diehard, it gets ugly. Too passionate, it gets ugly.
This joint is fire.
I actually
man.
Love that joint. This joint is actually fire. This joint is definitely a vibe. I'm not sure where it's going as far as concept,
uh-huh.
But like, I feel like so far, definitely a jam. Shout out Blast. This girl, Amanda Reifer.
Yeah, they smoke the hook.
Smoking it.
I wonder where I lost my way. Been waiting on your call all day. Tell me you in my corner right now. When I fall short, I'm leaning on you to cry out.
Die Hard, it gives me all of the stars.
Definitely type of vibe. Me all of the stars type of vibe. And then Kendrick Lamar was just talking about being like a like the name of the song, like a Die Hard.
Yeah.
Fucking with the person that he's fucking with.
Yeah.
I keep trying to connect everything to the title, Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers. I'm thinking, okay,
this is Mr. Morale.
You really need therapy the fuck you talking about?
You heard his response to the therapy? The girl, I don't need no therapist. I don't need no therapy. Everybody need therapy. Shout out to black women. And shout out to just all of the girlfriends, wives out there. Because that is a common thing that they be talking about. Where black men, sometimes we just be like, nah, fuck therapy, fuck therapy. And it be our girl in our ear saying, you need therapy.
Yeah.
They the ones that get to see the vulnerable side of us. You know what I'm saying?
Daddy issues all across my head. Told me fuck a foul, I'm teary-eyed. Wanna throw my hands, I won't think out loud. A foolish pride. If I lose again, won't go in the house. I stayed outside, laughing with my friends. They don't know my life.
He's talking about time.
Daddy issues made me learn losses. I don't take those well. Mama said that boy is exhausted. He said go fuck yourself. If he give up now, that's gonna cost him. Life's a bitch. You could be a bitch or step out the margin. I got up quick.
Come on.
He's talking about time.
He's not only just talking about a man, you know, as a father. He's talking about time. You see how he said, Daddy issues made me learn
if he give up now, that'll cost him. Life's a bitch.
Oh, this the part where mental stability meets talent. Oh, this the part he breaks my humility just for practice. Tactics we learn together, so it loses forever. Daddy issues.
Early morning wake-ups, practicing on day off.
Mama said that boy is exhausted. He said, go fuck yourself. If he give up now, that's gonna cost him. Life is a bitch, meaning you don't even have time to stop. Imagine, this is Father, the song is called Father Time.
Oh, okay,
so while
yeah.
It also sounds like black fatherhood, he's also speaking from the place of time.
Damn, like you don't have time to wait.
Yeah. Like, if you give up now, it's gonna cost you.
Early morning wake-ups, practicing on day offs. Tough love, bottled up. No chase I need, no chase I need, no chase I need, no chase I need, no chase I need.
Daddy issues, hit my emotions, never express myself. Man should never show feelings, being sensitive never helped. His mama died, I asked him why he going back to work so soon. His first reply was son, that's life, and Bill's got no silver spoon. Nigga, when Kanye got back with Drake, I was slightly confused. Guess I'm not mature as I think, got some healing to do.
Wow,
egotistic,
right.
Zero giving.
Cause it could have never been me.
Cause it couldn't have been me. That's
when Kanye got right back with Drake, I was really confused. And everybody called me crazy when I said it.
Did they call you crazy?
People were like, why do you want two black men to be beefing? Why you want to be black men? I guess I'm not as mature like y'all man Kendrick. That's crazy to hear him say that, though. He said he was going to be speaking on y'all top fives.
Assistance with the way I was brought up. What's the difference when your heart is made of stone and your mind is made of gold and your tongue is made of sword, but it may weaken your soul.
Love how the first verse kind of paralleled with time and the concept of time. And he got real deep into like black fatherhood and what his daddy issues did for him.
One thing that needs to be talked about is the production on this album so far.
For sure.
Definitely stand out. Like, I appreciate it. I appreciate the message. I feel like this is more in line with the Heart Part 5 in a way, where with the, you know what I'm saying, still keeping that energy going.
Talking about parenting, I love the end where he was like, if you didn't grow up with a father.
Yeah.
Like, now you can give those blessings to your toddler.
Yeah.
Give the women a break.
Facts, man.
Love it. You can tell this Kendrick is older.
Yeah, like a more mature Kendrick. Even though he said he don't think he's mature.
Because of the Drake shit.
I'm surprised he said his name, though. Those names. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Saying
Kendrick, yeah. Kendrick is of that ilk of, I'm going to say your name. Yeah, and I've been doing it since 20.
After that, he literally said, egotistic, no fucks given, to be specific, something like that.
Yeah. Love that, though.
I like that one.
Because a lot of people was confused by that. It was like, y'all had so much smoke with each other, and now y'all standing next to each other?
On a stage because of this nigga Jay Prince? Who?
All right.
Right. Rich interlude.
I learned in trapping in the business. Smart people making horrible decisions, you know? Rich nigga get my dick sucked after the show. I ain't gonna lie, we were poor. This the type of shit we glorify. Everybody gang. Most of the people that you grew up with, not in the chain gang. In the box getting pink. Nigga shit where you sleep. Nigga shit where you eat. Who ever knew that I'd become a fucking Kodak? Rap money good, but I'm still putting the gas through the hood. Dropping all plates to the fam like Thanksgiving. What you doing with Kendrick? What you doing with a legend? So what they call you? When it's all said and done, we ain't leaving empty headed. That's on game. That's on Mon Dukes. Pour it in the business, but you fall through.
That's a crazy, crazy story from Kodak. Talking about, I love how he said, whoever thought I'd be a fucking, become a fucking Kodak. It's actually like Kendrick heard that y'all was saying that it would be funny to put Kodak on the album, and he just said, I'm gonna do it.
Wow, that's crazy as shit.
Well,
no
maybe
bullshit.
Somebody had an insider tip and was saying it on some funny shit like they knew.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That was an interlude for real. You know what I mean? Like, not really to be played again, but just a message on the album.
As Kendrick does frequently, like for free or...
Yeah.
I've been cool writing testament, painting pictures, put me in the Louvre, that's a definite universal shift, I'm in the groove, a celebrity do not mean integrity, you fool, I'm a good man, shake your hand, firm grip rule, 72 wins, lost 10, balling with the flu, more than 2 M's, for sure, but add another 2.
That's the flu game, right?
Yeah.
72 A's, lost 10,
but balling
with the flu, Jordan,
more than 2 M's, but yeah,
I'm the GOAT.
Nah, you're right. You got it.
Stop playing with me before I turn you to a song. Hey, bitch, I'm attractive. Can't fuck with you no more. I'm fasting. Bitch, I'm attractive. AP, Michael Friedman, my friend's cooler. Primary soda resale face stupid. I would never love my life on a computer. IG, I get you life for a chickabooya. Boy, power, stop playing with me before I turn you to a song.
Stop playing with me before I turn you to a song.
Hey, bitch, I'm attractive.
Can't
fuck with
you
no
more. I love it. I love it, and I love that third verse for some reason. I love that second verse.
The way that Kendrick switches his flow every song, we don't really know what we're gonna get.
He's a professional.
I just feel like I love it. And I feel like this joint definitely had a little groove to it.
All the y'all that are about to try to make think pieces tonight, because we're doing this shit the night of, they were like, all these people that are about to try to make think pieces tonight, you're tripping. This is... It's going to take you a minute.
It's going
to
take
you a minute. It took me 5 years to do the damn documentary. Five years.
5 years of listening, not getting
five
it.
5 years of not getting it.
Yeah.
But skipping XXX.
This is what the world sounds like.
Confrontational ass dumb bitches. You wanna bring a nigga down, even when I'm trying to do right. We can go our separate ways right now. You can move on with your life.
Now he talking for real. You heard what he said.
Y'all forget
come
that.
On, man.
Kendrick talking.
Kendrick definitely said this is what the world sounds like.
You a part of it. He better get into his superior man shit, probably. He better start saying, y'all niggas whining, y'all niggas crying.
Nah,
he
I don't
about
know. I think
us.
The lady's about to come back crazy.
You gon' move on with your life.
Fuck you, nigga. You love a bitty party. I won't show up. Always act like your shit don't stink. Motherfucker, grow up. Forever late for shit. Won't buy shit. Sit around and deny shit. Fuck around on a side bitch. Then come fucking up my
what,
shit.
Fuck you, bitch.
Fuck you, nigga.
Nah, fuck you, bitch.
Nah, fuck you, nigga.
Fuck you, bitch.
Nah, fuck you, nigga.
Nah, fuck you, bitch. Tripping, okay. I held your ass down.
You just cut me down, that's a big difference.
Bitch,
give me my fucking keys.
Nah, I like you parked in that bitch.
Give me my keys, bro.
Oh God, you ain't getting these keys.
Give me my fucking keys.
Ah, now you mad at me. I got you hollering for nothing.
I do the same when we fucking.
Act like that pussy ain't loose.
I'd rather act like I'm coming.
I'd rather fuck off the juice.
I'd rather fuck on your cousin.
Bitch, you said you gon' fuck who?
You heard me, nigga, all right. It's nothing. You know, nah, fuck you,
no.
Nigga.
You bitch.
No, fuck you, nigga.
Fuck you,
fuck
bitch.
You. Speak, then I'm called on my name. I am flawed. I am paid. Never yours. I remain. You the reason bitches start fucking with bitches when they change. You the reason. You the reason Harvey Weinstein had to see his conclusion.
Damn.
You the reason R. Kelly can't recognize that he's abusive.
Damn. Shut the fuck up. We all know you still playing this music. Said I'm tired of these emotional ass, ungrateful ass bitches. Fake innocent. Fake feminist. Stop pretending.
Pussy nigga, best watch your mouth.
Pussy and mouth is all you got.
Lay this pussy back on the couch.
Doggy style, then you get on top.
Fuck me, nigga.
I'ma fuck you, bitch.
Nah, fuck me, nigga. Fuck me.
I'ma fuck you, bitch.
Nah, fuck you. Stop. Fuck me.
You playing, man.
Fuck me.
Nah, you
Kendrick
playing.
Kendrick Lamar is low-key the goat, bro.
That's crazy.
That's beautiful.
Rest in peace to John Singleton, who put that on film for y'all to see. That is so real.
I have tears in my eyes, bro. That's how you know it's
good,
bro.
That is such a real situation.
That's how you know that
so
that shit is good.
So many couples' lives. John Singleton, put it on wax, put it on film first, to me, in the rawest, most realest format, and Baby Boy. Explosive argument, makeup. I knew that was coming. I just needed him to do it, and he did it. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Shout out to Taylor Page. She killed it. I don't give a fuck what y'all say. Did y'all just hear that performance? That was like watching a fucking movie.
It was.
What rapper? Name your guy. Name your guy. What guy? It's no more talk. This is what we do. This is what we want. This is what I want. Give me some shit that's going to sit with me for a minute. I don't need to go back and bump this in the gym. I don't. I want to experience that though. That was amazing. That was the world speaking. That was women's opinions and men's opinions.
She low-key bodied.
She was smashing him, bro.
But the one thing he said at the end that stood out to me, because he's also a nigga in the industry, is why R&B singers don't feature on each other's songs. Like he was saying, it's women like you and it's real victims.
Yeah.
And he was like, why they don't? That's the only part that stuck out to me, because like, you in the industry. You're in this industry. When you look at these people on Instagram and you see the couple picture where they hugged up or whatever, it's not always sunshine and rainbows. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes right. It's true war. Big Stepper.
I know y'all love it when the drugs talking, but shut the fuck up when you hear love talking. Shut the fuck up when you hear love talking. If God be the source, then I am the plug talking. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. My life is like forbidden fruit. My bitch know better than I do. A woman's worth. I barely went to church. I'd rather fast with you.
God.
My life is like forbidden fruit. My bitch know better than I do.
Whew. That's a hell of a way to show your woman love. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And is this woman named Whitney? Is that why he keeps saying Whitney told me? He keeps saying Whitney told me. And I'm like, is K-Dot's wife named Whitney?
Whitney. His wife name
so
is Whitney.
So when he refers to Whitney, first remember he said Whitney told me. That's crazy. All right, let's go.
I don't trust that your intentions. I'm not in the music business. I've been in the human business. Whole life been social distant. Hoes like when you not tripping. I duck the party. Who said they saw me? Crown on by Molly. Wrist on your gun. I know y'all love it when the drugs talking. But shut the fuck up when you hear love talking.
That's an amazing track.
I hate it here. Baby daddy still on my phone. I hate it here. Asking if I've been on a prowl. I hate it here. If you keep lurking on the low, if you a fan, just let me know. Love if you gon' judge me for my past. No, it ain't love if you ain't ever eat my ass. It ain't love if you just only tie me down because you see me in my best.
That's a fact,
fellas. If you never ate the ass, you ain't really in love.
Do you love her for real? Think about it. Ass eating, let's keep it 100. You don't never say, I'ma eat your ass right now. Yeah. You know? It just happened because just you love her.
And you know what? A lot of y'all that like to fuck drunk, I know you ate ass.
You ate ass.
You ate ass. Ass.
You did.
I like that, man. I love Summer Walker. Speak for the ladies, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And man, shout out to K-Dot Jalike for this joint is one of the ladies' tracks. This is Jalike a ladies' track.
Nah,
you know
for
what I'm
real.
Saying?
They could, yeah, and you know what's crazy? I was thinking, I was listening to this joint. I said, damn, Kendrick made, we're finished at this point. We're finished the first album.
Mm-hmm.
I said, God damn, I like everything.
Smack Death and held it to that nigga Cabbage. Nah, we killing greed, we killing homelessness. And I don't give a fuck about this land. I want ownership.
Yes.
Brand I know y'all love it when the drugs talk, but shut the fuck up when you hear love talk. Shut the fuck up when you hear love talk.
I love how he said, shut the fuck up when you hear love talking. If God is the source, then I am the plug talking. I am him. I love the Ghostface verse. Niggas like Action Bronson, a lot of these niggas, even all the way down to a West Side that have that tone.
Yeah.
Ghostface walk. First, so niggas like that could run
with that tone.
So it's just great to hear him in 2022.
We may not know which way to go on this dark road.
I've heard of you. Album 2, let's go.
One of these lies, I'ma make these right with the wrongs I done. That's when I unite with the father, son. Till then I fight. Rain on me, put the blame on me. Got guilt, got hurt, got shame on me. Got six magazines that's aimed at me. Mass on the babies, mass on the op, wear mass in the neighborhood stores you shot. But a mask won't hide who you are inside. Look around, the reality's carved in lies. Wipe my ego, dodge my pride.
Wear mass in the neighborhood, mass where you shot. But mass won't hide who you are inside. Look around, the reality's carved in the lies.
Dog. I love when you count me out. 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 Fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fucking it up. How you gon' wear my shorts when the lies run deep? How you gon' bend your love when the bed don't sleep? Deep beat crash our feelings in the middle of the street. Fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up.
You said I feel better if I just worked hard without lifting my head up. That left me fed up. You made me worry. I wanted my best version, but you ignored me. Then changed the story. Then changed the story.
Good energy in the room, drop the location, please.
Sounds like tap dancing. And it was tap dancing at the end of the first track. And if I'm not mistaken, the first
or
track.
Or stepping.
In this joint, it's called Count Me Out. And each of the verses, he kind of talks about a different layer of people counting you out. And, you know, the people you love counting you out. But in that third verse, it seemed like he was kind of talking about counting himself out. Like, you said I feel better if I just work hard without lifting my head up. That left me fed up. You made me worry. You made my version. You wanted my version, but you ignored me. He was talking about, like, and then he was talking about, at the end he put, I put it all in my ego, Lord of all lords, sometimes I fall for it. And honestly, that's some real shit. This song.
And at the end he's talking about, like, Miss Regret, right? Miss Regret, can you please leave my house or some shit?
Yep.
Is that who he's talking to, you know what I'm saying? Is he talking to
Miss Regrets? I believe you done me wrong. Miss Regrets, can you please exit my home? Miss Regrets.
Think about it. Would Miss Regrets be the person that told him if you just work? Because he said, I got regrets. Yeah. If you just put your head down and work, then you'll be fine.
And maybe he's regretting that.
Maybe he's talking to this Miss Regrets that, look, that done him wrong. Please exit my home. Like, I need regrets to leave me. I don't want no regrets. You know how they say that? That's why he's saying.
And this is kind of like the him getting out of that regret. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
By saying, Lord knows I try my best. You said it's not my best. I came up out of my flesh. Some things I must confess. I pay my debt. They were like, this is me. I am blessed. Anybody going through the stress? And then he gets cut off. I cannot wait to listen to this joint again.
For the time it goes, and I'll be there when somebody needs you. You say no, and all you've done gives them amnesia. One thing I've learned, love can change with the seasons. And I can't please everybody. Can't please everybody. Heavy is the head that chose to wear the crown. The home has given much, is required now. Heavy is the head that chose to wear the crown.
The home. That's it. And it's crazy because everybody wants to be the king, and they always say heavy is the head that wears the crown, but honestly, people just say that and they don't really understand. Like when you are the king or when you are at the top,
yeah,
it gets, number one, it's harder to please yourself. And you just have to come to the realization that you're not going to make everybody happy.
Yeah.
And the more people you in charge of, the more people that look to you,
mm-hmm.
the more you realize you cannot please everybody. Especially, I can't imagine somebody being a rapper. I can look at it from an organizational standpoint. When I used to work, they would say, look, I used to tell my team, you're not going to be able to please everybody on your team. Somebody's going to be mad at you for something, or you're going to miss a birthday. You're going to miss something. You just got to be vulnerable, accept your shit, whatever. As an artist, it seemed like you would have your whole family trying to get shit from you.
You got,
you know, can you help me with this? Can you help me with that? Anything.
And you can't please everybody. Mm-hmm. I got to tell some people no.
Yeah. And I like how he said, heavy is the head that chose to wear the crown.
Right.
Normally, it's heavy is the head that wears the crown, but I think adding chose in there is good because, like you said, in these managerial positions or any position of leadership that you're in your life, you do make the choice to do that.
Yeah, you signed up for this.
You sign up for it. So, like mm-hmm. he said, to whom is given, much is required now. Like, but I can't please everybody. It's going to be one of those tracks that probably mean a lot to this album mm-hmm. if we go back. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. Brand new Kendrick Lamar, 2022. Let's get it.
Push these niggas off me like, push these bitches off me like, push these niggas off me like, pushing the snakes, I'm pushing the fakes, I'm pushing them all off me like, pushing them all off me like.
Let's see Terrell hate on this, because there's no way you don't like all them other tracks we listen to. Go ahead and hate on this.
What?
This you can't like. Because of the
They sound like some Playboy Cardi shit, but I'm gonna let Kendrick
rock. He didn't like pushing P. He didn't like for a nod. He didn't like.
I don't like shit like this.
He didn't like.
I don't like the. I'm not a real big fan of shit like that.
Pushing these niggas off me like
I mean, it's cool. It sounds like Playboy Cardi though. The beat. This sounds very Cardi. Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But you got a goat on it though.
Playboy Cardi is a goat too.
Don't be immune to shit. Tucking the broom and shit. Done with the zoom and shit. Know you a joke, my answers are close. I holler at the moon and shit. Know the results, the ballot is in, man. I'm about to boom again. You funny, dog. Peekaboo, can't hide behind your money, dog. A week or two, I meditate on running log. Push these niggas off me like, push these bitches off me like, push these niggas off me like, pushing the snakes, I'm pushing the fakes, I'm pushing them all off me like. Pushing them all off me like,
huh.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about
that.
Y'all know I'm a fuck
I
with
know
that.
You fuck with that. I don't know how I feel about that. Kendrick?
I mean this. They don't fuck with me even if they could. Pull out the stick, hit a bitch with the wood. First part roll was breaking the hood. Don't worry about us over here, we good. The AP Roman numeral. Everybody go and need pharmaceuticals. I ran my whole conglomerate. I was just mapping shit out in the cubicle. Suicide cool is a funeral. Track hot lines like a slingshot. Big ol' ruby diamond on my pinky finger, that bitch look like a mini pop. When I'm stressed out,
shh, be quiet.
I'm stressed out, stressed out.
I don't know how I feel about that joint, man. It was very Playboy Cardi-esque. I don't know why I got a Playboy Cardi vibe, but my misplaced there, I don't know, I could be. I thought Kodak's verse was dope, but I thought it was just kind of like 16 bars too long.
Yeah, I thought Kodak's verse was a little long.
But I liked it, but I don't know if I like that.
Yeah, like,
I don't know if I like that.
Terrell, that's definitely not in your ballpark of what you would like.
It reminds me of those ski tracks.
Pushing these niggas off me like,
It sounds like some Playboy Cardi shit. Like, if this was a new Playboy Cardi track, I'd be like, that nigga got a little lick.
Yeah, but since
I just Kendrick. Expect more from Kendrick. It's funny, because Kendrick is stressed as fuck.
It sounds like he's singing about it. Shit. Stressed and sick of all of the shit that y'all got going on, low-key. This is definitely one that I'm going to go to. Silent Hill, I'm going to go back to this one for, like, the jam, the activity shit.
Yeah, I know. I just feel like I'm going to play it too.
I'm stressed out. Like, can I not
relate? I'm stressing right now.
And that's why I told you he looked stressed on the beginning of that part five. He just looked like he came from, remember when I said he looked fresh out the pandemic.
You ever see him? Mama strung out while you studied division. Your uncle ever stole from you day after Christmas. Seen both of those in the county jail visits. The first and the 15th, the only religion. Noodles in the microwave, Shark Tank tidal wave. Grandma shooting niggas blood on the highway. Crosses on the dashboard, you just want a platform. I want to take everything that I asked for.
I thought what Baby Keem did was dope because it sounded like he was speaking from a real place of like real experience. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Then it started just talking about kind of, then he just kind of basically started just, you know what I'm saying, kind of like flaunting himself, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I expected to see Baby Keem on the album, Kendrick's little cousin.
Yeah.
But
I don't really care for that.
It was all right. I mean, I thought it was long.
I'm not a huge Baby Keem fan. I don't think that his rapping ability is as good as Kendrick's. I think he is as witty and shifty.
It's
but
like,
I don't think he's saying
but this is
much.
People call me a Baby Keem hater all the time on Twitter.
because I'm just not that big of a fan, because he doesn't do anything spectacular for me. And I always was like, I always used to say, it feels like the Kendrick camp is forcing Baby Keem on us. You know what I'm saying? And he has a nice little niche fan base. It just came out that Kendrick wrote hella songs for him. So when I said he wouldn't be on without Kendrick, I was 100% right. And even this, Kendrick wrote it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You look at the writer's credits, it's Kendrick. And so it's like, we didn't really need this. It was cool, but I couldn't live without it. If I'm being completely, that's me being keeping it 100, not being subject to, oh, he's related to Kendrick, so I'm going to be a fan of this nigga. And this is what you call Kendrick saying in that first album, what, this family going, what did he say? This family going, something he said, but this is that family tie right here.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, because this, it's all right.
Pun to use, family ties.
Yeah.
They won a Grammy for that.
Kendrick made you think about it, but he is not your savior. Cole made you feel empowered, but he is not your savior. Future said get a money counter, but he is not your savior. Brian made you give his flowers, but he is not your savior. He is not your savior.
Mr. Morale, give me high five. 2 times in a code of finish, judging my life. Backpedaler, what they say you do to cha-cha. I'ma stand on it, 6'5", from 5.
What? In the Apple lyrics that I have right here, you know I have the first downloaded. Remember? Soon as the album dropped, I hit play and been playing. It says, Ye said to speak loud, but he is not your savior. But on your screen right here, it says, Bron made you give his flowers. It's like the day
they must have and remember we couldn't get the joint.
Remember we couldn't get it to play.
They must have re-edited the joint.
They must have said, I don't know. But maybe not for that. But like that's just something that I'm you literally see it right here. Ye said to speak loud, but when you click that, it says Bron. Look.
Bron made you give his flowers, but he is not your savior. He is not your savior.
Mr. Morale, give me high five. 2 times in a code of finish, judging my life. Backpedaler, what they say you do to cha-cha. I'ma stand on it, 6'5", from 5'5". Fun fact, I ain't taking shit back. Like it when they pro-black, but I'm more caught at black. Ay, CC, wait a minute. Ben aquí, c'est la vie. I tell the whole truth from A to Z. Ay, show me you real, show me that you bleed. Ay, hello, crackers. I seen niggas arguing about who's blacker. Bite they tongues and rap lyrics, scared to be crucified about the song, but they won't admit it. Politically correct is how you keep an opinion. Niggas is tight-lipped, fuck who dare to be different. Seen a Christian say the vaccine mark of the beast. Then he caught COVID and prayed to Pfizer for relief. Then I caught COVID and started to question Kyrie. Will I stay organic or hurt in this bed for 2 weeks?
Come on, man.
Seen a Christian say the vaccine mark of the beast. Then he caught COVID and prayed to Pfizer for relief. Then I caught COVID and started to question Kyrie. Will I stay organic or hurt in this bed for 2 weeks? You really want to know?
I like what he said before that. Politically correct is how you keep an opinion. Niggas is tight-lipped. Fuck who dare to be different.
He said, seen a Christian say the vaccine was the mark of the beast. And then when he caught it, he prayed to Father for relief. Like, damn, I should have got the vaccine. Then Kendrick said, I caught it. And I started to question Kyrie. Because Kyrie was like, I'm not getting it. But since I'm sitting here sick thinking, damn, Kyrie, I don't know.
Will I stay organic or hurt in this bed for 2 weeks? And remember, you got to take a two-week break.
A two-week quarantine.
From COVID.
Beach, are you happy for me? Millie, are you happy for me? Smile on my face, but are you happy for me? Yeah, I'm up the way. Are you happy for me? The cat is out the bag, I am not your savior. I find it just as difficult to love thy neighbors. Especially when people got ambiguous favors, but they hearts not in it. See, everything's for the paper. The struggle for the right side of history. Independent thought is like an eternal enemy.
Man, the entirety of that song is in the first part of verse 4. The cat's out of the bag, I'm not your savior. I find it just as difficult to love thy neighbors, especially when people got ambiguous favors. They hearts not in it. Everything's for the paper.
Mm-hmm.
I'm about to fake.
And that's the culture right now.
And he talked about like the political correctness of shit and how people be fake political correct. But also, I'm not going to be the one to save you.
I rubbed elbows with people that was for the people. They all greedy. I don't care for no public speaking. And they like to wonder where I've been, protecting my soul in the valley of silence. I think that's him basically saying that he feels protected by not
saying anything. I'm not about to come
out here and trying to lead people
Right.
Maybe Kendrick Lamar takes on that thing that Malcolm X said, you know what I'm saying? Where he said, like, we got to stop looking to entertainers for leadership. Like he said, yeah, Tupac dead. You got to think for yourself. The enemies is going to turn into the villains for help. And it's like,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? I don't know if he's talking about himself figuratively there or if he means, like, you know what I'm saying? Because he's not going to be the savior because look how they did Tupac, you know what I mean?
Right.
I'm not going to be the savior and try to get out here and be in the media and speak my mind and talk about the powers that be every in front of these media outlets and stuff like that because they heart not in it. It's for the paper. And yeah. I'm really fucking with this shit.
I think it just goes to show how society is so... People look to their favorite artists for how they think.
Yeah.
And that's why I love how you said that in the beginning of the song with, like, Cole told you to empower you, but he's not your savior. Like, you really got to start thinking for yourself, for real. Like, yeah, all right, bet.
Your favorite rappers aren't your leaders.
And this is huge for Kendrick to say that because Kendrick fans...
Look at him like
cling to his every word, like, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Very real from him.
This is how we conceptualize human beings.
Oh, that thing. This is how we conceptualize human beings.
Monty is a man now. I think I'm old enough to understand now. Drinking Parmesan with her hat turned backwards. Motorola pager off-white guest jacket. She said, ain't no telling. Niggas always been jealous because he had more women. More money and more attention made more envy. Calling him anything but broke was less offending. My auntie is a man now. I think I'm old enough to understand now.
This is crazy.
We cool with it. The history had trickled down and made us ignorant. My favorite cousin said he's returning the favor and following my auntie with the same behavior. Demetrius is Marianne now. He's more confident to live his plan now. But the family in disbelief this time, convincing themselves he ain't living discreet, he's fine. He promised the world we living in was an act on abomination, and Demetrius was to blame. I knew you was conflicted by the feelings of preacher man, wondering if God still call you a decent man. Still you found the courage to be subservient just to anoint, until he singled you out to prove his point. Now, I said, Mr. Preacher Man, should we love thy neighbor? The laws of the land of the heart, what's greater? I recognize the studies you was taught since birth, but that don't justify the feelings that my cousin preserved. The very second you challenged the shit I was kicking, reminded me about a show I did out the city. That time I brought a fan on stage to rap, but disapproved a word that she couldn't say with me. You said, Kendrick, ain't no room for contradiction. To truly understand love, switch position. Faggot, 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 we can say it together. But only if you let a white girl say nigga.
Okay.
How do you feel?
I don't think anybody's petitioning to say the F-bomb. You know what I'm saying? And I think it comes with... I don't really like the end of that.
Because I don't think that word is equivalent to the N-word.
It's not. In terms of the word being the most derogatory thing to say about a certain lifestyle, sure.
Right.
But... The N-word.
The comparison to the N-word is where it's like, oh no.
The N-word was literally used to financially, systemically oppress for 400 years to the point where because of the way you look, you are literally 3/5 of a man. You weren't even considered human, but you were considered just a nigger. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's different than just, you know, nobody knows that you're gay when you walk in the room until you open your mouth. You can't hide being black. You know what I'm saying? You really cannot. It's different.
And for me, we got called that word while we was hanging from trees. Then was the last words that people heard, millions of us heard.
There's millions of us in the sea.
Before we died, you know what I'm saying?
There's millions of people in the ocean that didn't even make it here. So to me, it's a little bit different. I got to listen to it again. I thought it was...
The stories itself in it was still great.
Was still crazy.
You know what I'm saying? Definitely. It's just the end definitely threw me for a minute. But you know, now we're getting political based on.
Yeah. My auntie is a man now. And then Demetrius is Marianne now. Crazy. And the song is called Auntie's Diaries. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Honestly, it feels like a track that would be made in 2022. I don't know how I feel about it, though, y'all. I don't know. I got to listen to it again.
I want to listen to that one again, too. I love the storytelling. I felt like it's classic Kendrick Lamar telling us a story. I love the rise of that beat. It was a storytelling beat that did have a crash in. You know what I'm saying? I mean, we might not agree with the end a little bit too much. I think in 2022, we shouldn't be saying the F word.
I don't think anybody is.
You know what I'm saying?
People shy away from saying that before they say the N word.
Before they say the N word.
You know what I'm saying? You can say the N word on TV. You can't say, you know what I'm saying? They could call you a nigga on TV.
Yeah.
But that's just, it felt a little agenda-y.
Just detox my call and it's right on time. Transformation, I must have 1,000 lives and like 3,000 wives. You should know that I'm slightly off fighting off demons that been outside. Better known as myself, I'm a demigod. Every thought is creative, sometimes I'm afraid of my open mind.
Shit on my mind and it's heavy.
In deep meditation, my spirit's awakened, my brain is asleep. I got a new temperature, sharpening multiple swords in the faith I believe. I think about Robert Kelly. If he were molested, I wonder if life were failing. I wonder if Oprah from closure, the way that she posted the hurt that a woman carries.
Right there. He said, I think about Robert Kelly. If he wasn't molested, I wonder if life will fail him. I wonder if Oprah found closure, the way that she posted the hurt that a woman carries. Oh my God.
Yeah, people don't talk about that enough.
Yeah.
At the repast, they serving Popeye's chicken. What you know about black trauma? Heffin is kicking back. It's another genre. Tyler Perry, the face of 1,000 rappers using violence to cover what really happened. I know somebody's listening.
Tyler Perry, the face of 1,000 rappers, used their violence to cover what really happened.
He said, what you know about black trauma? Half in this shit, kicking back is another genre.
Yeah.
So if you think about it, this is Kendrick talking about black trauma and how it's used in movies. This how you know we don't be talking about nothing on a podcast. Even K-Dot. Look, talking shit about Tyler Perry.
Yep. I know somebody listening.
Watching my cousin struggle with addiction, then watching her firstborn make a million, and both of them off the grid for forgiveness. I'm sacrificing myself to start the healing. And
shit on my mind and it's heavy. Tear you in pieces because it's way too heavy. My diamonds, the Joker is heavy.
That is crazy.
I got little cousins right now that they all good as hell in sports. I'm firmly convinced that they all gonna go to the league, and then that side of my family, I'm gonna have to be like, yo, cuzzo, X.
Yeah.
See if he can get us tickets. Yeah. You know?
I could go to any Memphis Grizzlies game.
Yeah, and look, he played for anybody.
Yeah.
I say, hydrate, it's time to heal. Say, you're frustrated, I can feel.
And that's Mr. Morale. Man. Some of the realest shit on this album is said on that track. Spin it back and open this eye right here.
Yeah, man.
Cause boy.
Don't let that beat fool you. You know what I'm saying?
I'm sensitive. I feel everything. I feel everybody. One man standing on two words. Heal everybody. I wake up at night. Loved her daily. Traded in my tears for a Range Rover. Transformation. You ain't felt grief till you felt it sober. And blue, the image of my queen that I can't erase. Till this day, can't look her in the eyes. Pain is taking over. Blame myself. You never felt guilt till you felt it sober.
Wish you were somebody.
It's already an impeccable track. Crazy.
In black families, the devastation haunting generations and humanity. They raped our mothers, then they raped our sisters, then they made us watch, then made us rape each other. Psychotic torture between our lives. We ain't recovered, still living as victims in the public eyes. Who pledge allegiance? Every other brother has been compromised. I know the secrets. Every other rapper sexually abused. I see them daily burying their pain in chains and tattoos. So
man, I'm not gonna lie, bro. I really fucked with that one.
It was heavy, but it was so raw. Vulnerability.
I just loved what I loved. I could not wait for her to say that last part of the little bridge so that he can get back to telling another
yeah
story. I can listen to this man do that for hours, man.
We listened to 5 years, but we've listened to Kendrick 13 years at this point, if you count on nine. But, what was I going to say? Oh, we listened to Kendrick for 10 plus years now, and I think that's one of the most vulnerable that he's ever been.
I was just about to say, this is Kendrick low-key letting us know that, yo, I made it famous, but like, I really come from a real life. And I don't think that y'all really understand for real.
Right, no, really.
You know? He said something about spending time in nature, and that's how he, like, really copes. And yeah. It's like, damn, I always say it must be a hell of a life to be famous. Y'all think y'all, everybody wakes up every day and we're on the path to success. But yeah. If you actually were successful as fuck and didn't really have to do anything, it's like, damn, like, that would be a different way of life.
And the fact that he talks about addiction. It's yeah. Like, you really never know what your favorite's going through. You think they're just working on an album for 5 years when they're really going through some real life shit.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I like how he said, like, is this the one? Am I tripping? Oh, no, that was Mirror. Where he said, you ain't experienced this until you experienced it sober. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, you ain't experienced pain unless you felt it sober. Like, I gotta go back and listen to it, but
it honestly crazy. And I love hearing Wifey and the baby at it.
Love it. You can tell he's a father. He's had two kids in between this last album.
Yes.
Them kids young.
Yeah.
So as a dad, damn, I'm a dad now.
Of two.
And I love the Baby Keem, Hope He Made You Proud.
Yeah.
The pressure's taking over me. It's beginning to loom. Better if I spare your feelings and tell you the truth. Lately I redirected my point of view. I choose me, I'm sorry. Personal gain of my pain is nonsense. Darling, my demons is off the leash for a mosh pit. Baby, I just had a baby, you know she need me. Working on myself and counseling is not easy. I choose me, I'm sorry.
And that's it. Kendrick Lamar, Mr. Morale, and the Big Steppers.
Ooh.
That actually felt like the last Kendrick Lamar album we'll ever get with that ending to me.
Yeah.
He sound like, I choose me, I'm sorry. It sound like he's saying, I'm not making music anymore. I'm dead ass.
Honestly, we don't know what's to come. I mean, this is his last studio album with TDE.
Yeah.
And so now he's off to do his own thing.
The last lines in this song, I'm sorry to cut you off, Terrell. He said, yeah, sorry, for sure. I didn't save the world, my friend. I was too busy building mine again. I choose me, I'm sorry. Times 10 going out of the song. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. Honestly,
regardless of what y'all think that I might need to do with rap and get out here and just show that y'all I'm the GOAT. And people are saying, where the fuck Kendrick at? Why he ain't rapping? This is him basically saying, yo, I actually chose to go and have a family.
And yeah,
and you know,
changes.
He talked about how Whitney, his wife, had to wait them 7 years of him touring with no kids.
Yeah. It's to be said that people change. It's like, they say kids really change your life. Shout out to all my folks out there that have kids, right? Like, it really will change your perspective on some shit. Like, all right, I kind of just like want to be here for this. Damn, what was I looking at? What movie was I watching? Or some TV show or something. Somebody had kids and they was like, you know what? I'm getting out of this shit because I want to be here for this. I can't think of exactly what I'm thinking of, but people have kids and say, you know what? I think I might want to be here for their whole years growing up, and I don't want to go through what I... If y'all think Kendrick going on tour, it's not happening.
I don't think so.
After what we just heard, it don't sound like
it
he's
going
on
like
tour. He's going to want to be there for them kids.
I think about what his wife said. She said, you did it. You broke a generational curse. Kendrick grew up a life knowing that my father's this way. Look at my aunt. Look at my family. Yep. We don't come from nothing. In my music, I broke this curse.
I broke my generational curse.
And he talked a lot about wearing the crown in this album and it being very heavy. We kind of saw the same thing in all of our artists. The Drakes, the J. Cole's, even Kanye, of them all speaking of living on a higher side of life after success. It's crazy to hear everybody, our guys talking about life changing and being more serious as we start taking life more serious.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
It's honestly, I can't formulate an opinion on how I feel about this album.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just yeah, I love it. I love, just off the first listen, which tape do you like better?
NPS, that first tape.
N95.
I'm sorry, I said NPS. N95, that Rich Spirit, We Cry Together.
I gotta re-listen to this joint to see where it places.
I think this solidifies K-Dot in the top three of best all time, and I always say that. I think what Kendrick Lamar has done for hip-hop, as far as a storyteller, I feel like we won't get it. I feel like he's one of a kind. He's a one-on-one. I said Kendrick was... I said he was top three best all time 5 years ago in the Heart Part 4 video, and I stand on that, man. I feel like, look at what he gives. It's just such a real raw hip-hop. And just to kind of close out, it's like, damn, what was I about to say?
Real quick, let me see how much we have left on this, because I remember we had 2 hours and something.
Yeah. I knew he was going to be good.
18 minutes,
yeah. But, Mr. He's, damn, what was I about to say?
You said just to close
out. Oh, because you said that you didn't think it was good. I personally think that the album was great. I think we have a lot to dissect. I think you got some songs that you can bob your head to. But we all know that Kendrick Lamar has given us nothing but subject matter. I felt like,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? This lined up next to his other albums might not be that great. But I feel like it's like the dunk contest where if you get 350s, remember your next dunk, you can just do whatever. Not saying he's let off the hook if this album's bad and if people find it bad in any way.
Do you think, but why are you saying that like that? You saying it like it's not good and.
No, I'm just saying because I don't think that this one needed to be this. I don't think this needed to be better than Damn and To Pimp a Butterfly and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because your last showings were all great. So I didn't look at this one like, yo, he better put out the best album of Kendrick ever put out.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I just wanted Kendrick to be Kendrick, and we got it. So,
yeah. Put your thoughts in the comments, man. It was a journey. It's 3 a.m. over here.
Yeah.
And Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers, Kendrick Lamar, Mallory Rose.
Yes, sir, man. Shout out to the Realest Nine watching on Patreon. You seeing this first.
Yep.
Turn up, man. If you're watching on YouTube, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button. But definitely, definitely, definitely check out all the exclusive content we got on Patreon, man.
Yeah, for sure.
Only $3.
Yep. And shout out to all of the people that are new Patreons that are watching this that just kind of
turn up,
jumped in because it's Kendrick. We got a lot of cool shit. If you are a new Patreon, I would tell you to go back and look at that damn documentary that we did a couple months ago. Where we broke down the damn album. While you here,
Terrell's masterpiece.
Yeah, while you here in this month, you might as well take advantage of all of the stuff that we have. And look, stay for next month, and the next month, and the next month,
and the next month, right? And last but not totally not least, shout out to the Mallory Bros Podcast. 100 episodes.
100%.
In this weekend, each and every Friday, we showing up for y'all.
For sure.
On YouTube and all DSPs for podcasts. It's lit in the city, man.
If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button, dog. And if you've been here, make sure you get the notification bell so you get the notification when we drop. And Bruce Wayne.